We are doing a pivot of a long format table and make it look like a wide format table. So the table on the left under original, that's original table. And you can see you have different IDs there, 1 to 6, but most of them have multiple rows. What we really wanted to do is to create one row for each unique ID. They have multiple IDs, multiple rows for each ID because of column 2, which is the test name. And say for instance, on student 1, he or she had taken test ABC, and then you have on the third column, you have the corresponding score, right? So we really wanted to convert this one into a wide format wherein instead of having three columns, ID test scores, we want the ID, and then the next columns will be however many number of tests there is in this data. And then under those test names are the corresponding scores. All right, so we have two tasks in here. The first one is what we have on the table right now. So each one of the students have taken the test once. Like even student number 6 who have taken 4 tests, he had only taken A once, B once, C once, and D once. So therefore, there is no, not a single student in here who have taken a test multiple times in order to say get a higher average or a higher score. All of the tests are unique to each one of the students. So that's our first tasks. First task. The second task that we'll have is what if, say, student 6 have taken test C twice because he's wanting to get a better score. So that's the one that we will do on the second one. Okay, so let's put this one back in here. All right, so we will use Power Query to do this, to clean this data and also to transform. Well, this is actually fairly clean data, but more on transforming it. There are many ways to go to Power Query Editor. For now, what we're going to do is just click on any one cell in your original table, and you go to data in your ribbon, and there is this icon here. One way to load your data or get your data is called from table slash range. We're going to use that. And as you can see, it has basically enclosed that area more or less where the table is. Is this really what we want? No, not really, because that first row original, that's not really part of the table. But just for the sake and fun of it, we'll take it. Okay. So let's go. Okay. All right, so let's look at this first on this table. First things first, I'm gonna like delete this. I was working on it earlier, so we don't really need those. Okay, so we uploaded our table. It's called table 14. In this area right here, you'll see the list of queries. For now, we only have one table, so that's the only query that we have. In the middle area is the preview of your table or of your query. Right now we only have 15 rows, including the header, and so you can see it. It can see all of it. But if you have a really big data, it will only show like the first 1,000 of your row. On the right side, you will see some properties of your query. In fact, I'm gonna name this one My Table. Okay. And as I change that, automatically on the left side, the name of the queries is also changed. Below your properties, you have the applied steps. So these are the transformations, the things that you have done to your table. It will be listed here. Okay. Well, the first thing we wanted it to do, of course, on top will be the tools, the ribbon, the things that you can do to your table. First thing we want to do is this row one should be the correct headers, right? We want to get rid of this column headers because they're not really the actual headers. We want to move ID test scores as the name of our columns. And that's easy enough to do. Before we do that, look at on under your apply steps. Right now you only have two lines, right? The source and change type. So now we're about to do one transformation, and that is to move the first row as headers. Under home, use first row as headers, click on that, and now automatically your headers are now changed. But also in your apply steps, you added promoted headers, right? So in if Say for instance you have something done, you have done something wrong, all you got to do is just X them out and it's back to where it is. Okay, so well, we want to actually move that headers up there. Okay, all right, what we really wanted to do is to create a pivot. So first thing that you have to do when you're doing pivot, as long as you have a visual in your mind of how you'd like to do it, it's easy enough to do. Well, you want the test column to be your new columns, right? You want to create a column for A, B, C, D, and under those will be the corresponding scores for each one of the student ID. So therefore, if the test column is the new columns that you want to create, then highlight that on your ribbon. Next to home is transform, and then you have this pivot column. And there are more or less two things that we need to fill in. First one is the values. Well, the values is what data do you want to be in under those new columns that you have? Well, we want the score. We don't want a student ID, right? You want the score. And then after, under advanced options, the aggregation function. You don't really want the sum. Like say for instance, one student have taken a test multiple times, you want the sum. If that's what you want, go for it. But for now, we really just want to show the score. So we will do don't aggregate and say click okay. And this is your preview now. First column is ID, and then you have the next four columns as your test data. All right, we want to see this so that we can see it side by side with our table. So go to home, close and load to. All right. I want to load this one as a connection just because I want to show it to you. All right, click OK. Now, on the right side, the queries and connection will populate. Let's say you don't see it. Okay, you open and well, what's going on? There's nothing here. Well, you want to see it, so you go to data. Under data, you have queries and connection. And again, now you have your queries. This is like the one written on the left side of your Power Query editor. I want to see the table on this area right here. Okay. Now, if you have done it here, then your table will populate from this cell down to the right. But so I want it here. So therefore, I'm gonna put my cursor in there under your My Table. Click on that just to highlight it. Right click right now, load to, and now we want to load it to a table. Okay, and then I'm gonna close this one for now. I want to make it a little bit okay, so I need to see the headings. All right, so let's do that. Let's widen this a little bit so it's not too close to each other. All right. Well, this is our final table, and look at that. We only have six rows, unique IDs, and then the first column is A, similar to that. In fact, it's equal to that, and also C and D. So we have successfully pivoted a long format table into this format. Now, our second task is, what if student six have taken C twice? Okay. All right, what if he's taken it twice? So therefore, if you imagine it, this depending on which one you want to show. If you wanted to show the average of two scores, you can do that. If you want to do the maximum of the score, they can do that. If you want a minimum, so depending on what kind of aggregation you want. But this time, I just want to see the highest scores. So I want to capture 92. So if you think about it, this table would have been similar to that, but column D would be gone, right? And you will only see 92. Because that's C. Now, if say for instance they have taken B twice, okay, let's do that. B twice, you still want the maximum score, then column C for six will be empty and this one will be 92. That's what we want to show. So let's do that, okay? I'm gonna capture this table again. I will not just refresh because I don't want this table to be overridden. I want to create a new table. Okay, so I'm going to capture this table again, go to data from table in range. Okay, I have a new table. I'm going to rename this by double clicking. I'm just going to name it second table. Very intuitive. Can use better practice a good naming convention, the one that will make sense to you. Okay, All right, well, same problem. We want to promote these headers. So under home, first row was headers. We're good. Now we will pivot, highlight the column that you want to be new rows, I mean new columns. And let's do the same thing like what we did earlier. Okay, I'm gonna go to transform, I'm gonna go to pivot, and then the values is still the score. And let's say we still don't want to aggregate, okay? We're just showing you what will happen if you choose that. All right, if I look at column D now, there is this red bar, and under ID number 6, you have an error. And let's click on it. Why is there an error? Well, the details, it says a list. So what is this list? You have, remember, student 6 have taken D twice. 35 and 92 were the scores. So there is a list of scores. That's what this error is saying. Well, I did for the pivoting, they don't really want you to create a list. They want you to give like the aggregation. Either you want the sum, the average, the count, the maximum, the minimum. You choose one, but not a list. Okay. All right. Well, we're stuck on this page. What do we do? We want to go back so that we can correct. Well, you go to your applied steps. You can just X this one out. You go back there. I'm going to X this one out because I want to pivot it again correctly. I'm going to highlight test. Go to transform, pivot column. We still want the score on the values. But under advanced option, this time I want to capture the maximum score by student per test. Okay. You can do average, but this time I want to do maximum. So now I'm going to click OK. I'm going to load this one up again. You go to home, close and load two as a connection. You can, of course, load it as a table right away, and it will create a new sheet in here or a new tab. But I want to create a new connection, and that will be the second table here. We want to load this as a table now. I'm going to click here because that's where I want my table to start. Highlight the second table, right click, load to as a table. Okay. Let's close this for more real estate. Let's widen this a little bit so we can see them all. All right. So is this what we expect for the second table? Yes, it is. So student 6 does not have a test C anymore. Student 6 does not have a test C, only has A, B, D, and for test D, we just want the maximum score. All right, I hope this helps. I'll see you on the next one.